Hello everyone, my name is Maria Dolores Sánchez Galera. I am a lecturer and researcher of the Pascual Madoz Institute of the Carlos III University in Madrid, in Spain. I'm very thankful to the editors of STALS, especially my friend Giuseppe Martinico, for giving me this opportunity to share a few words with you about my new book, Educational and Cultural Challenges of the European Sustainability Model, Breaking Down Silos in the Legal Domain, that has been recently published by Springer. And well, the monograph is an attempt to be a renewed inquiry of the almost worn-out issue of sustainable development by shedding light into methodological difficulties of traditional disciplinary approaches when addressing the neglected cultural and educational aspects of sustainability. It presents an innovative research agenda, especially from the point of view of legal science. The contribution is a modest approach to note how disciplinary boundaries are not any longer valid to find sustainable solutions, neither to suggest alternative solutions to mainstream trends. The book aims at encouraging lawyers and policymakers to turn their attention to education and cultural matters, considering that they remain a vital issue for a change of paradigm that our society needs today. I note that there are hints of partial attention to education and culture in public policymaking and international agreements and international initiatives that are directly influencing local approaches, but there is a lack of serious engagement in these matters of innate interdisciplinary nature by academic and practitioners. The contribution examines the importance of a global and systemic analysis to understand better our regional and local context in which the interconnected world is already present and where solutions are more effective when educational and cultural public institutions are engaged. I suggest a groundbreaking perspective on how the theory of sustainability transformation should be connected to more systemic analytical approaches for successful actions in which lawyers need greater involvement. Drawing from what seems a strong worldwide leading regulatory model on sustainability and environmental protection, the main purpose of this book is to show how the most important parts of such a regulatory puzzle are missing: culture and education. These matters should be at the forefront of present and future social transformative initiatives, together with the idea of common good if we want to build a stronger sense of intergenerational justice in Europe and beyond. A good sample of European initiatives within the context of educational and cultural policy following eco-narratives and common good paths are enshrined as a corollary of the analytical part of the book in Chapter 5 to suggest a better perspective of how we can face the educational and cultural challenges of an unfinished European integration process investing on sustainability transformation. I also indicate how public institutions need a serious reform under this light, departing from similar intentions behind the acclaimed transformation sought by the United Nations 2030 Agenda and the SDGs. The European Sustainability Model has been apparently built as a robust normative model, integrating environmental protection with world-leading regulatory systems of energy management and production, transport and mobility, sustainable production, circular economy, corporate responsibility, and green financing. But this model is still weak in what seems to be the hard bond of the European pride, the social contempt of sustainability policies, including welfare, social justice, education, and culture. The conceptual context of the book lies on the current social, political, and economic European crisis. I try to argue how Europe is at the crossroads mainly because the cultural and educational challenges of its economic development project have unfairly neglected the internal and external challenges of the European Union sustainability model, comprised geopolitical imbalances in the energy transition, threats to the economic and social cohesion, growing cultural diversity, increasing social and political complexity, uncertain political trends at national levels, the climate crisis, and last but not least, endangered legitimacy and trust. In the context of ever-increasing globalization and ecological perils for the Earth, Europe has a strong responsibility as a global actor, and this book advances the idea that the Europe sustainability model is under pressure. So, through the 6 chapters of the book, I really try to conceptualize and understand better Education and Cultural Challenges of Sustainability for Transformation, Raising Awareness on the Big Picture and Exploring New Conceptual Frameworks. And well, despite the Anthropocene rigs, the political disrupts and the pressing social problems, I believe, and I show that through the monograph, that Europe remains a civilization project characterized by a rich institutional infrastructure and cultural heritage extremely equipped to face future challenges. But these infrastructures are still insufficient and cultural and natural heritage need further attention. I think the book presents a valid and useful research agenda for academics and practitioners considering the aftermath of the pandemic and looking at Europe today in the midst of complex and interconnected transformations at all levels. So thank you. Thank you very much. Bye.